Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Hope you all are doing good there, and I'm doing good here as well. Friends, thank you so much for all the love and enormous support you are showing to me and to my channel. Stay connected to me. So this video is going to be about Malaysian craft alone, which is a world famous one. So friends, keep watching and enjoy the video. So friends, one of the very important Malaysian craft is a wooden craft. So they call it as a living craft as well, and it is used for a livelihood of the people over there. So there are many varieties. There does a many varieties of craft out of wooden, and I have picked only few. So we'll share with you all whatever I bought it for myself. So friends, Malaysian craft, art and craft is a very huge one. So kindly excuse me if at all I have left anything else, because this vlog is purely about my personal experience when I visit over there. So whatever I was explained over there, and whatever I observed and whatever I really felt, it's very lovely. So I have picked those things only, and I'll be sharing those things alone with you all. So if at all any important things is missed in this video, kindly excuse me, because this is completely it's a personal travel vlog. So friends, whatever I observe, whatever I come across personally, I'm just sharing with you all in this video. So friends, this doll is one of the wooden craft, and this doll's name is pack doll. That's how I was explained, because in one single doll there are many sizes. I think some 6 to 7 pieces of dolls are kept, and it's packed in one single piece, so it is called a pack doll. Actually, I was looking for a pair, like boy and girl, but I couldn't find, and this pretty lady was lying there, so I quickly grabbed it. So once the wooden is craved accordingly, and it is, the art is done over by the art people in the same batik, then it is brought into a display for sales. So that's how the process is made over there. So friends, these are many, there are many different varieties in this, many different size are there, many other things are also, they used to make it into different sizes like pack dolls, but I picked this pretty lady because I loved it. The eyes were so beautiful, so I got attracted to that, and the color was very catchy, red and blue and green and yellow. So immediately I took, and I'm using this for decorative purpose, and it really looks very gorgeous when I decorated my house. So maybe in the home tour video you can see I have decorated this. So friends, the another wooden craft was this wooden bowl. There were many different shapes and size and varieties were there, but then still I picked this bowl because it really looked very beautiful and very catchy. So I immediately took this, and the painting which was done over this bowl was really fantabulous, because even though after washing so many times, this paints never leave. It doesn't go, and even if you use the scrubber, even I use the scrubber also, the paint never left. So it was really good, and the paints are very strongly caught into that. So that one thing was really amazed. So I bought in this some two size of bowls, and so one I kept for display. And the another thing was a beautiful mirror. I don't know, it was very cute and very small, so I immediately picked that one. And this one is a wooden chair and table. It is very small, but they made it very beautiful, so I picked this one to keep it in a showcase, and so I just bought this one. And this is 4 different types of cups, so I picked it also. So friends, another important thing was Malaysian stones and beads. There are many types of stones with various colors are available, but the stone which I explored and the things which I bought out of that was jade stone. So they make beautiful garland out of that stone, beautiful necklace, beautiful bracelets, and some few showcase purpose. So here I picked one bracelet and two necklace out of the stones, and some mixed stone with some beads were made in that. So they added something in that, and also I saw the person who made this. I really got so carried away the way they make it with so much of love and so much of patience and so much of passion for the art and all that. So I really loved the way, and this necklace I saw how the process has been undergoing with one ordinary that stone, what all they does. So I was really carried away watching all that. So usually I don't buy, I'm not that crazy for jewelries or clothes, but when I saw this people, when I saw the things like how they does and what are the process it undergoes, I really got very carried away and tempted, and so I grabbed this three pieces. And also it looks very gorgeous. So different types of stones and different types of beads. And the person who explained to me said that it bring lot of luck. And yes, of course, I guess, I believe. So I don't know. I mean, yes. And so I took one photograph also out of this, wearing this necklace. And it really suited me. I guess, because usually I don't wear all this type of things, but so friends, another craft was candle making. They used to make it in the form of diyas and in the form of other shapes and size. So this looked very beautiful, and I picked so many, but I gave it to my friends and only this was left. So I thought this, my son actually wanted to have it, so I gave this to him. And to share with you all, I just picked from him back. So friends, this candle holder is made up of clay again, and then it is dried, then it is the beautiful light arts are made over there on that. And then the candle holder has a candle stand like, which is made up of wood. And even the inside, it is properly nailed, and you know, thin sticks are given for support. Everything is neatly made. And I saw the person who made this so much of, with so much of love and patience and so much of skill they put into it. The flower in the shape of the candle in the shape of flower like this. Many other shapes were there, like butterfly was there and some other flowers were there. And so many things, so many different types and so many different sizes were there, and so many all various types of fragrance were used. So it really looked very gorgeous. So I bought few, and only one piece is left with me now. So friends, hope you all like this video. I'll be sharing few more things on Malaysian craft alone in the next video. So stay connected to me and to my channel. Spread positivity and stay positive till I meet you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.